Yo, what is up, guys, and welcome back to another video, or should I say story, because today we got a pretty cool story, and you guys really want to stay tuned for this, because it's going to get down to shit. And, well, today's story is about my stalker. Believe it or not, I did have a stalker while I was growing up in middle school, and she was pretty intense, guys, like, intense. But she was crazy. She was crazy, guys. She was crazy. And so, well, I'm just going to get into this because it's a really crazy story and you guys really want to stick for this. You want to stay here for this story because this story was intense, exciting, thriller, suspense, you know, all of the above. So, betrayal, that one's right there, man. So, pretty much all this stalker stuff dates back all the way to the time when I was in sixth grade, okay, guys? In sixth grade, you know, I wasn't, for you guys wondering, that was not elementary school for me. For me, that was middle school. So I did have a middle school. I did not go to a junior high like most kids do, but I went to a middle school, and in this middle school, there was, you know, 6th, 7th, and 8th. So in sixth grade, I had all my typical classes, and then I got an elective. First semester, I chose computers. Second semester, I chose art with my friend. And so, we did art, and we're having fun. And so while I was in art class, I noticed this girl that was there. And she was quite lonely, and I felt bad for her, you know? So I went over and talked to her, right? And this is how it all started, okay? This chick that I'm talking to right now is the chick that stalked me. And so I just went over there like a nice person, and I told her, hey, hi, nice to meet you. My name's Val. And she's like, oh, hi, nice to meet you. We're just gonna refer to her as, Brittany, all right? Because I know her name. I remembered it, like, legitimately, like, 30 minutes ago. I just remembered it, like, 30 minutes ago, and I was like, wow. I can't believe I remembered that name, but we're just gonna call her Brittany for now, because I don't really know anybody called Brittany, so I mean, yeah, why not? So Brittany said, oh, hi, my name's Brittany, nice to meet you. And then, well, like, at first she was kind of like avoiding me because I just like said hi out of the blue. She was like, oh my god, who's this guy? But later on we started getting to know each other, and it was fun, you know. She was cool, I was cool, and we were like those friends where like you would pass by in the hallway and you'd say hi to you understand me? And so, yeah, it became, like, those type of friendships and stuff. And it's fun to have those friendships. But, like, you just kind of say hi, like what I was saying. You just kind of say hi and you don't talk too much unless you're in the same class, like, the same class type of friends. So, yeah, we're those type of friends. And then, like, so, and then it was over. The school year was over and it ended. So then, yeah, the school year was over and then she left. All right, guys? And so, that was good, man. I was good. I was set for life. Seventh grade, I was set for life. All right, guys? 8th grade, I was set for life until the field trip. I know all of you guys who have ever been in junior high, elementary, or in high school know when you're finished with that certain type of school, you always get this like field trip at the last end, like the end of the grade, you know, the last grade of that that school. So for our trip, we went to Knott's Berry Farm. Really fun place, by the way, guys, to go with friends, especially when they had that new ride open where, like, you can shoot stuff. It was really cool, by the way, guys. Wow, that ride was the bomb. And so, yeah, I went over there with this girl named Michelle. She was my crush, guys. I have to say her name, Michelle, man, because, man, every time I say that name, honestly, guys, I get really happy because I really did like her a lot, and that's for a different story, guys, because I totally screwed it up. And so, you know, I was rocking it with my friends, and so, There was Michelle, her best friend, like her bestest friend in the world, and then she had this chick. I'm just gonna call her Brittany. Brittany. I don't know. We'll just call her Katie. Katie and Brittany. Katie was Brittany's sister. Katie was Brittany's little sister. So I went on this trip with them, and me and Michelle were hanging out. Well, not really. She was kind of avoiding me because I was a little weird, and I totally screwed up things. I screwed things up at the beginning. That's for a different story, I'm telling you guys. And so, her, like, bestest friend was there. And then Katie, you know, the little sister of the stalker, said, like, you know, she's, like, that kind of person where, like, she says, hold my stuff, I'll be right back. And she kind of leaves for, like, an hour or an hour and a half and comes back out of nowhere. And she's like, oh, my God, are you guys ready for this? You know, like, that type of person. She did that. And she came back out of nowhere. She's like, let's go on the log ride. And so, For those of you guys that don't know what the log ride is, the log ride is like pretty much you get inside a log at Knott's Berry Farm and like you do this little splishy splash, you know? Like it's pretty fun, guys. It gets addicting a lot. Like you always want to ride it, which is fun. And so yeah, she came over. She's like, let's do log ride. And then we're all like, yeah, sure, why not? Because who doesn't like the log ride, right? So we get down to doing the log ride, and my computer's super laggy right now, but let's hope that does not affect the audio quality, okay? But we're on the log ride, we finish it, and then when we're done, we go to the monitors to check out our picture, right? We're at the monitors checking out our picture, and like, you know, the Katie, the little sister of the stalker, says, I'm gonna buy this picture. So she just buys a picture, okay, guys? She buys a picture. And you know, she like sends us all the pic, like she said, like she takes a picture of the picture that she, the guys, that's a tongue twister. So she took a picture of the picture that she bought from the picture. Yeah, okay, yeah. So yeah, she sent it to us. God damn, that's hard to say, you know. She sent it to us, and so we all got it, and it was fun. And then she's like, oh my god, Val, do you remember my sister Brittany? And I was like, no. And because I totally did not remember her. And I'm like, who the hell is Brittany? And she's like, you don't remember Brittany? She's like, you used to talk to her a lot in sixth grade. She's telling me you guys were like the bestest friends. And I'm thinking, yo, my only bestest friend in sixth grade were like the people I like hung out with. Like, because in sixth grade, I used to live in apartments, guys. And those were like my bestest friends that lived there. And I was thinking, I don't know anybody else who would be my best friend. And she's like, you know, Brittany, she's like, would it be cool if I gave you her cake so you can like talk to her? And I was like, yeah, sure, why not? And so Brittany, of course, started texting me probably like an hour later, or, you know, whenever she gave it to her, because it was like, it was constant, guys. As soon as she got it, she was constantly on it. And so she shot me a text on Kick. And by the way, guys, if you guys don't know what Kick is, it's like a messenger, yeah, it's like a messenger, but like, it's pretty cool. I like it a lot. But yeah, so she sends me a message on Kick, and I go ahead and answer it, and I tell her, hey. She's like, remember me? Oh my gosh, art class. And you know, she says the teacher's name, and I'm like, who are you? Because I'm totally confused at this point. I'm thinking, who is this person? And then she's like, you don't remember me? I thought we were like best friends. You're telling me we're best friends? Guys, if you meet me, the only like true best friends I ever like have is the people I Skype every single day, man. And you guys know who you are. And if I don't do that, then you're not like my bestest friends. But pretty much I say that to like everybody else, because they're good friends. I love friends, man. And so yeah, she's like, we're best friends, you said it. And I was like, yeah, I don't remember you. And then she kept saying like all these things, and then like she reminded me. She's like, I used to sit by the drying rack for like the paintings. And I was like, oh my gosh, I remember you. And then I was like, oh my gosh. I was texting her. I was like, oh my god, it's nice to see you again. Nice to talk to you again. Oh my gosh, how are you? She's like, yeah, well, and this was what, eighth grade? So right now, she was a sophomore, guys. Okay? That's like right at the edge of eighth grade ending. She was a sophomore. But, you know, this goes on to like eighth grade going to ninth grade and her going to junior, becoming a junior. And so we're talking, and then she kind of types too much. You know those type of people where like when they're like talking to you, they send like five different like text messages at the same exact time, and they're like, hey, how are you? I was just wondering. And then she's like, if we could maybe, you know, go somewhere, or you know. And then she like sends all these things in like five different types of messages, and like she was that type of person, you know, and that just like broke your phone. That would turn your phone into a woman's toy, a vibrator. You guys feel me? It was that bad. Like when she texted you, it was legit that bad. And so I would always try to do stuff to like try to like get her that I just like try to like make her know that I don't want to talk to her because she's typing too much. And so I just started kind of like smoothly avoiding her over time, like not just like completely like stop talking to her. I smoothly just kind of like gently pushed it in there where like I just avoided her, you know, where you like, you say, what are you doing? You're like, nothing. You kind of like make the conversation die every time. So that's what I was doing. And it got to the point where I wasn't responding. And like, when I didn't respond, guys, she sent like seven hays. She's like, hey, how are you? And then she's like, oh, I see the message delivered. Your phone is probably not working. And I'm like, damn, dude, this chick is savage as shit, man. Guys, you won't believe it. She was insane, man. And so And like, I didn't read the messages, but like, I did after the time when I found like with like the next messages. I'm getting into it, guys. So like, and then I just kind of stopped talking to her, right? And she stopped talking to me. And so like, what? A week later, 2 weeks later, you know how you guys are always like, whenever you guys, if any of you guys out there, like I'm trying to relate here, if any of you guys out there have Skype, Kick, Outlook, I don't care, any of those messaging thingies, you guys know what I, like, I'm talking about when we say that like there's always chatbots trying to get you to like some weird site, and they're like, put your credit card information in there. Oh, sorry, I hit the mic. But they're like, put your credit card information there, and you'll be signed up. You know, there's always bots like that, and you're always clicking on them because they're hot. You know, come on, guys, let's be real, let's be honest here. And so, that's what I did. She like text like this random person texted me, and she says, "Hey, I just had you in my Kick contacts. Do I know you?" And I was like, "No." And so like, the first thing, guys, if you're ever like talking to someone new, first thing, don't message them unless you've seen them face to face, which was my bad, because I still messaged them. And always check their picture quality. If it's not like HD, like 180 HD, they're most likely a bot, because every bot has a crap ass 420p 189p horrible resolution. Okay, guys, but so she sends me messages, and so me and her are talking, dude. I'm like, oh, hey. She's like talking like a real person. I'm like, dude, this person isn't a bot. Oh my gosh. And I was so happy because, guys, the profile picture was on point. And she, it was like, I was like, oh my gosh, dude, this chick is really pretty. She's like, she's really outgoing, because, guys, if you ever knew me, I'm a really outgoing guy. I love like sharing my like details, guys, because it's cool if you guys ask me anything, man, because I'll totally share it with you guys. And so like, so she was outgoing, I was outgoing. We're like having these great conversations. We're getting intimate, you know, like we're like sharing like details about different parts in our bodies. And then she was like, oh my gosh, this is so cool. And you know, we're all like saying all these different things, and we're still keeping like, we still got that spark in the conversation, right? And so like, and then we're just like talking, and this goes on for like what, 2 or 3 days, right? And so after that, after 2 or 3 days, my friend says, hey, Val, I'm going to the bowling. I'm going to go bowling with, this is Ashley, by the way, guys. Ashley's a really good friend of mine. She's like, I'm going bowling with Chris and like Jose and all these other guys. Those guys are really good friends of mine. And I said, yeah, sure. Would it be cool if I can take someone though? And they asked who, and I was like, this chick I just met. And they're like, yeah, it'd be fine. Okay. And I was like, yeah, okay, awesome. And so I text a girl, that like random person that texts me. And then she's like, yeah, I would, like, if I could. I can't though, because my dad is very strict. And so when she said this, I was like, oh, pretty much every little girl, you know, every girl out there, well, not little, I shouldn't say that, that makes me sound like a rapist, but like pretty much like every like girl out there has a strict dad about boyfriends, you know, because they want to watch out for the little angel. You guys understand me? So I say, hey, it's fine, just tell them you're going with like your girlfriends or something, and like, just we'll meet up, nothing bad's gonna happen, we're gonna go bowling. And she's like, yeah, but like, he'll find out. And I'd be like, do you want me to talk to your dad or something to assure him that we're gonna go bowling? Because I was just like, I really wanted to meet this girl, dude. She was like perfect, okay, like, wow. And I really wanted to meet her. And so I think I have a picture of her. I don't know. I might put it up or not. I don't know. But I just really wanted to meet her. And I was like, okay, awesome. And so she's like, no, I'm sorry, I can't go. And she made up all these horrible guys, these lame excuses. And it kept going. It kept going for like a lot. And I was, and then it just got to the point where I said, well, okay, then she's not going. And I was like, all right, whatever, you're not going then. She's like, oh, thank you for understanding. And so, and then the next day came, and I was like, hey, what school do you go to? Because she was texting me like she knew me, like straight up. And I was like, I've never met you like before. I never told her I never met her before, because damn, she was hot, and I didn't want to ruin that opportunity. But then she was like, oh yeah, I go to this and that school. And I was like, really? Because Ashley goes to that school. And then I started going into this like full mode, like detective agency, like psych show. If you guys ever seen Psych, that's a really good detective show. Love it. And so I go into like that type of mode. I'm asking her all these questions. What are classes? What are this? And Ashley's all like, I don't know her, dude. I've checked, like, I know all those classes, I know all the people in there, and I've never heard of her. And I'm like, really? And so, like, I start asking her all these questions to the point where she says, okay, Val, I have to admit something to you. I've been lying to you the whole entire time. And guys, when someone says that to you, your heart drops out of your ass. Okay, guys? It doesn't drop to your stomach, bro. That shit drops out of your ass, bro. Cause that thing guts you like, what the fuck, you know? And so, like, she tells me this, and guys, man, I die, okay? I'm thinking, man, oh my gosh, I'm dead. I'm never gonna see the day of light again. You guys know what I'm talking about, right? And so that happens, and I'm like, oh my gosh, is this real? And I kept telling her, you're joking, right? This is just a joke, this is a prank, right? And she's like, no, I'm serious. And guys, at that point, I kept asking her, are you serious? Like, this is not a joke. I constantly kept asking her, and she's like, I'm serious, I'm so sorry, Val, I shouldn't have done this. And I was like, what's wrong with you? Okay, guys, I didn't just say what's wrong with you. I said a lot of bad words in there. I said a lot of bad words after that. And I told her, who really are you? And she says, oh yeah, I'm Brittany. You know, the girl that was texting me nonstop, that texted me like 5 hays because I didn't respond in like 5 minutes. Guys, and then when she said that, I was like, because we shared every single detail, guys. And that's what, when like, it's bad. All right, guys, that's what happened. And then I was just scared, guys. And then so I just completely said a bunch of stuff to her super horribly. And then like, she's just like, she was like, I'm so sorry. She kept apologizing, and I made that bitch suffer, you know? But like, oh man. And so like, she like kept apologizing. And I kept saying, nope, we're done. All right, I never want to talk to you again. I never want to see you. If I see you, I'm gonna go all out on you. You understand me? Not like punch her, but like, I'm gonna go full out, like roast her ass like a Popeye chicken. You guys feel me? But like, it was like that type of thing. And I told her, don't ever talk to me, don't ever see me. And I was really pissed off, guys. And so she kept saying, I'm sorry. And then like, I completely blocked her. And then she made new accounts to keep saying she's sorry. And it just got to the point where you're like, really, dude? Really, are you serious? And it's just, and then that's my stalker story, guys. That's pretty much the stalker story. That sums it up for you guys. So you guys can imagine, this all started because I saw some chick that was hot and I never met her before. So guys, pretty much the moral of the story is, don't go around talking to some random ass chicks you haven't seen or talked to, like face to face, like face cam Skype type of crap. You know what I'm talking about? Like, you have to see them. Like, you have to see their face move, okay? Like, that's pretty much. Talk to them first, face-to-face. Then you can be sure to talk to them on any type of messenger you use. Because if you don't make sure, stuff like this can happen to you, man. And it sucks, guys. Speaking from experience, it sucks ass. It sucks the most assiest ass of this ass. It was bad, guys. But thank you guys so much for watching, man. But yeah, seriously, man, don't do that, guys. Don't do that. It's horrible, guys. The experience of your heart dropping out of your ass, guys, it hurts. It hurts. It just doesn't hurt, though. It just gets you in those moments of phases where, like, you know when, like, say you forgot something really important. It's like those type of moments, and you're like, oh my god, I just forgot that, you know? It's like those moments. It's horrible. Worst feeling you can possibly feel as a human, guys. But thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys enjoyed, make sure to click that like button, because I mean, you enjoyed it, and so click the like button. Thank you. But if you guys did enjoy a lot and you guys just enjoyed regularly, it would be a lot of support if you guys could probably support this channel by subscribing and liking and commenting, because I do read all the comments and I love replying to comments because they like motivate me, you know. Whenever I read a comment, I'm like, wow. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and have a good day. Oh, and by the way, guys, I forgot to mention this. The gameplay in this is by, I forgot the name, but I'll link it in the description, guys, if you guys ever, like, want to see their gameplays. But thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed, and have a wonderful young grasshopper.